Today, I'm going to create some custom badges or shields to spice up our GitHub documentation. Stay tuned. And here I have social media banners, LinkedIn, YouTube, and down below you can see in tools some different banners for Unity, Autodesk, Adobe, Blender, and so on. You can customize the colors of the background, the logos, and of course the text. And there's the styles as well that you can choose. And if you stay until the end, I'm going to show how can you add this README into your GitHub portfolio page. Hi, I'm Dalton. Welcome to my channel. I'm a software engineer and game programmer here in the UK. If you want to know more about those topics, subscribe to the channel. And to create those banners, I'm using this amazing project called shields.io. You can create, as they say, concise, consistent, and legible badges. And we are going to create static badges. Simply, you can have a single background color or two sides. You separate the sides with a dash. You can have different background colors, either with the blue, for instance, or you can use hexadecimal values as well. If you need spaces, you use an underscore, and you can have up to 5 different styles and different logos. For the logos, you can check out simpleicons.org and filter between more than 3,000 icons. It's very cool. You can use the icons suggested default color. You could also check here the simple icons, the slugs file. Here you can check out the text of those different logos. Let's have a quick breakdown of a badge here in Visual Studio Code. I create a markdown file and put a sample banner here. You can pre-visualize it. We can use this extension called Markdown Preview Enhanced if you want, or several others should do the same thing. I can open and see on the fly the changes. So here I have an Xbox tag. Let's change to a PlayStation tag. Here I can filter by PlayStation, but let's pick this one here. I'll copy the color and have PlayStation as a name. Let's update the description for PlayStation. The first part would be PlayStation. The second part could be network. Here we should the background color here. Oh, and you need a dash to separate the color. Let's change the logo, PlayStation as well. Why not the website? And the style here, we can change for something like for the badge, more square look. That's it. And here is the gist that I create. So you and I can check this when we need to create those nice badges. I have a way to display it using HTML. Almost the same thing with a different format. You have the plain markdown and some examples of all the different styles using different things. And as a bonus, you can have down below here alerts from GitHub. So you can have those very nice, colorful ways to improve your documentation. The link is down in the descriptions as well. Oh, and if you need to download this, you can git clone in your terminal, or you can hit here download zip, or also you can inspect here the raw version of it. And as promised, I'm going to show you how you create this README in your GitHub portfolio. It's very easy. You can inspect the file here as well. So you just need to create a repository with the same name as your account. So in this case, my account is DaltonBR. I need to create a repository with the same name. And you can see here this green message saying that it's a special repository. And within that repository, all you need to do is create a README.md file and put the markdown in there. You can copy mine as a starting point. Of course, you can tweak and make it your own. And here on line 26 is where you have that GitHub banner. You just need to tweak your username and feel free to tweak these other details. So do you want to show icons? Do you want to showcase your private commits? The theme? This is just basic HTML. Feel free to tweak it. I add this down into the same gist. You can check there. And that's it. I hope you enjoy it. If you have more tips, suggestions, leave them down below. I would love to hear what else you guys are doing out there. I'm always interested in learning more about how can we tweak and make our documentation better. I see you in the next video.